Okay. Poor Red. I'm so sorry. You're at peace now. I can see Red now sitting here, guiding me. I probably wouldn't be standing here now if it wasn't for him. Why did he have to leave me alone down here? Leaving out how Red managed to catch and kill this thing is quite clearly inedible. Poor guy must have been close to starving to death. Chains on his arms are visible now. Not that out of choice, Barbara looks on aghast. He clutches some notes, shaking hands. He knows what has come, what the man has released, the only one who would stop it. Howard knows the real fear. Oh Jesus, from the stench I think this might have been his toilet. Ugh. How many hours did he spend with his neck in this noose just trying to end it all? No wonder he's getting hungry. With a final meal, rationed slugs. Ugh. The wires. I thought it was just a fuse box. This is what I need. And let's bow cut these motherfuckers. And that's it. I should be able to open the door now. Rest in peace, Red. As I stepped into the mouth of the underground facility, there should have been more questions. Fears, doubts running through me. Instead I was torn in two. Part of me I felt had died along with my only ally and friend. His final words had raised more questions than they'd answered, and I couldn't get screams for help out of my head, despite knowing, deep down, that the pain I had caused Red was itself all the help I could have offered him. I was alone again, but I had nothing to do, other than press on into the unknown. If I'd felt so bad about Red, I should have listened to him and stayed where I was. I would trade his fate 100 times for my own. The other side of me was looking forward to what might await me in the continued journey. I felt sure that I would soon find some clue or others in my father's fate, and that he was extraordinarily linked to everything that was happening. I also couldn't help but suspect that everything I had seen up until this point was just symptomatic of whatever lay beyond the threshold. I know now, I was right. Seems like a list of staff. Welcome to the shelter. Total population 57. Huh. Howard. Chief Translator. Howard. Please have your identity documents ready. I don't have any of those, but we'll see what happens. Oh my. Hello? Oh, that's something I did not want to see. Hello. It's locked. Hello? With that, the man who was first descended into the mine was no more, and so began my next chapter. To be continued.